The question is, why have the Chinese chosen this particular time to move? What is it about India's situation that has made China act in such an aggressive way? What is it about this moment in time that has allowed the Chinese to have the confidence that they can move against a country like India? And to understand that, you have to go into multiple spaces. Countries are protected not by one particular thing, but by a confluence of forces, by a confluence of systems. Okay? So a country is protected by its foreign relationships. It is protected by its neighborhood. It is protected by its economy. It is protected by the feeling that its people have, the vision that its people have. And what has happened over the last 6 years, that on all those areas, India has been disturbed and disrupted. And I'll cover each one of them. Let's start with foreign policy. Our relationship with the outside world used to be with multiple countries. We had a relationship with America, strategic partnership with America, I would say, and that is very important. We had a relationship with Russia. We had a relationship with Europe. And these countries used to help us maneuver in the world. Today, our relationship has become transactional. We have a transactional relationship with the United States. We have disturbed our relationship with the Russians. We have a transactional relationship with Europe. Now let's come to our neighborhood. Earlier, Nepal was a friend, Bhutan was a friend, Sri Lanka was a friend. Our neighborhood, other than Pakistan, was working with India and saw itself as being partnered with India. Today, Nepal is angry with us. If you go to Nepal and you speak to the Nepali people, they're furious with what has happened. Sri Lankans have given a port to the Chinese. Maldives is disturbed. Bhutan is disturbed. So we have disrupted our foreign partners. We've disrupted our neighborhood. Now let's come to the economy. Our pride, something that India used to go to the rest of the world and talk about, boast about. Worst economic growth, 50 years, no end in sight, absolute disaster, unemployment highest in 40, 50 years. So our strengths have suddenly become our weaknesses. We told the government that, look, please realize that we are becoming vulnerable. All these things are connected. They're not separate. When you look at a nation, you have to look at all these factors and you have to act, taking into account all these factors. We told them, listen, for God's sake, inject money into the economy. Fire the economy and do it immediately. Protect the small and medium businesses. They refused to do it. So today you have a country which is economically in trouble as far as foreign policy is concerned, in trouble with its neighbors. And that's why the Chinese have decided that this is possibly the best time to act. And that is why they have acted.